Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Davos 2019, and thank you very much. I also want to thank MTN for the wonderful partnerships in the Million Minds. It's actually 2 million minds today, and Nedbank as well as our partner, so thank you so much. So, and I also want to thank Irene Chandley for her push in terms of Million Minds, and one of the things we said was, when we brought Sophie, she said, yes, it's possible, we can do this. So Irene, it's your vision, your tenacity, and your drive, and I heard you never say no to anything. So thank you for bringing the partners, Nedbank and MTN, on board as well for us. Thank you so much. So today at 10:30, we're going to be having a live streaming to over 2 million people for Million Minds. In the room, we have about 200 young kids today. In the next auditorium, so you'll see them at some times today as well. As we think about, you know, technology can't replace the human touch, we live in incredible times. Over the next 10 years, humanity will change and evolve more than it has in the last 100 years. A lot of progress has been made. We're hearing that technology, disruption, a whole host of things that are happening. We'll see that our humanity is going to actually be very important, that we have to protect humanity more than ever in our lives. I'm supposed to change the slides. Talk about technology. Do I have the clicker? Thank you. Right now, development is testing is underway. As we know, contact lens are connected to the internet. We see swarms of nanobots remove cholesterol. We see driverless cars. We see fridges ordering food. All these things are happening. We're also seeing the first fleet of flying taxis. This is the future, is happening right now. We'll talk about technology in the future, right? Is nanobots, you can see it happening right now. And our contact lens. Thank you so much. Every day we'll see new roles, new jobs, new skills, new emerging. Technology has the ability to magnify the human genius. It can also compensate for human limitations, but it can never replace the human touch. Our technology reflects the humanity of our values, our beliefs. Humanity is what we are. We also see it in the world that we are built for ourselves, our children, our society. Humanity is about shaping our world around us. It's building a better and brighter future for all that we share in. Today, I want to share with you the five things that we should think about as we, as leaders and organizations, embrace technology. In order to survive in this world, we need to adapt to a new world of reality. We need to rethink what your workforce can do, demonstrate empathy, and unleash creativity, and embrace diversity and collaboration. If we are thinking about the world of technology, it brings a lot of fears in our lives. The fear of job losses, the fear of the unknown, and even the fear of robots taking over our world. No doubt machines will replace the work, but it is us as humans to protect humanity. It is us as humans to protect our people. It is us as humans to make sure that we reskill and upskill the workforce of today. We're hearing a lot of things around disruption. We're hearing a lot of things of unemployment. What are we as HR, as CIOs, as CEOs of our country doing? We need to take responsibility for our people and our society in terms of what technology can do. In terms of the new skills of the future, we are going to be seeing a lot of jobs that are going to be replaced. Like chief trust officer, in terms of algorithm bias auditors, business behavior specialists, and even cybercrime counselors. We're discovering new roles every single day. These jobs and the skills may not be applicable in the fields that you are in right now. But there are new jobs emerging every single day. But it's important that we understand what these new jobs are. If you're thinking about your organization, you need to think about what are the new roles that are created in your organization. Are we thinking about these new jobs? Are we, as HR executives, actually developing these new jobs already now? Are we actually hiring these graduates in terms of these new jobs? A little later, BCG will take us on a journey into the skills market of the future, I believe, in terms of what are the new jobs, and also give us some ideas and some case studies in companies that are actually applying some of these new jobs going forward. So I want to leave you with the thought that we need to invest in technology. We need to own technology. Technology should not govern us. We are responsible for technology. We create the technology. Robots are not creative. We are creative. Robots do not have empathy. We do have empathy, although we do believe that robots will have empathy, right? But I don't believe they will have empathy. They do not. In organizations, there are such things called chief happiness officers that are going to be created going forward, right? Is your organization creating that? So you need to think about what are the new roles going forward. The most important thing I want to leave with you is that humanity is here to stay. It is going to become a very important component of our lives. We are responsible, and we need to take care of ourselves and make sure that we take care of our citizens, of our country, and the world. You, each and every one of us, are responsible for humanity. We should not allow technology to... Technology is great and wonderful. It will help us. It will help us in terms of, you know, thinking about how we can handle diseases, in illness, and a whole host of things. But most importantly, we own the technology. So thank you very much, and hoping you have a wonderful Davos with us.